Good evening. Welcome to Vibin with Ashley Live. I'm your host, Ashley Live, the one and only. Tonight's episode is 121, and I have the beautiful and talented Cyniah Elise joining me. She's a singer-songwriter based in Atlanta, Georgia, and she started singing at a very young age. The beginning of her life, 2 years old, she started singing in the church. She hasn't stopped since. And in 2020, she was featured on season 18 of American Idol, and she finished in the top 20. And Lionel Richie described her voice as a young Whitney Houston. So Cyniah is in the room. We're gonna get this interview started, and thank you guys for joining us this evening. Good evening, good evening. Cyniah!
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Happy Saturday. How's your day going?
Going really good. How's yours?
It's going well. Thank you. And thank you so much for coming on my show. When I heard you on American Idol, I was like, first off, who is this girl? And when can I talk more about music?
Thank you for having me. I was very excited when I got the message from you. So I was like, I have to do this.
Yes, yes. And I'm so excited to learn a little bit more about your story, what's to come. You have a lot of good stuff happening in your life right now. So I start each show off with a song lyric. So tonight's lyric is going to be from Warrior by Demi Lovato, a song you know very well. So I'm going to say a couple lyrics from this song. You're going to either tell me what this song means to you, what it reminds you of, just clarity on this song. Sound good?
Okay.
Beautiful. Now I'm a warrior. Now I've got thicker skin. I'm a warrior. I'm stronger than I've ever been. And my armor is made of steel. You can't get in. I'm a warrior.
Okay, so to me, those lyrics mean, like, you know, different circumstances, like, you go through in life, and, like, how you just come out better.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty much what that means to me, like, if you're going through something in life and how you deal with it, how you handle it, it makes you stronger for the next situation.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. And all of Demi's songs have such a beautiful message behind them.
Yes.
What about that song made you want to cover it?
It was just a very beautiful song, and it's very deep. Just like you said, all of Demi Lovato's songs have, like, a deep message. And so I wanted to make sure that I could touch the crowd, because maybe somebody in the audience was going through something and they felt like they needed that win. Like, they needed to know that they were a warrior. So I wanted to, you know, resonate with the audience.
Yes, I love that girl power, empowerment, and giving people strength through the music. I think that's so powerful.
Yes.
So I want to start at the very beginning of your life. So you actually started to sing at 2 years old in the church. So what did music mean to you, and how did it shape your childhood?
So, yes, I started singing at two, and I grew up in a singing family, so my mother directed the choir, my cousin sing, my uncle has a church, and I sing over at his church sometimes, so it just really shaped me to be the person that I am now, because even with, like, simple song lyrics, I just find something that, you know, I gravitate towards. Like, music is very impactful, and, you know, it can kind of shift your mood in any direction.
Yeah. And I think the power behind music is so amazing, right? Like, if you're going through a difficult time and you hear a song like Warrior, like, oh my gosh, I'm not alone. Demi Lovato went through something like that. And I think it's so cool because music can put you in a variety of different moods.
Right.
So you, from a very young age, you were, like, obsessed with American Idol. Do you remember the first time you saw Idol as a young kid?
Oh, do I remember I just remember standing in front of this big, like, box TV. I got the thing in the back. It wasn't a flat screen yet. So I just remember being so tall, just standing there looking like, I could do that one day. And it happened.
Yes, yes. So you started watching American Idol and you were like, that's going to be me someday. I'm going to be on that show.
Yes.
What about American Idol, other than the singing, drew you to the show? Was there anything specific like, oh my gosh, I love the judges on the show, or oh, because there are some other singing shows out there, competition shows. So I'm just wondering what drew you to American Idol versus the other ones.
Well, what drew me to American Idol was that I've been watching it since I was younger. Like, there's other shows, but they're newer shows. Right. And American Idol just looks so fun to me, and especially with the judges this season, it was very fun, and I wanted to be a part of that.
I love that. So cool. So I want to talk about who you're inspired by as a vocalist. So Beyonce, Brandy, Tamar Braxton are just a couple of these beautiful powerhouse vocalists that inspire you. So can you break down each one of them individually and just tell me the impact they've made on your life?
Well, for one, they're all amazing vocalists, performers, and they're just beautiful. So, I love her, the way she commands the stage. Like, her voice is beautiful. Mm-hmm. Braxton, I love everything about Tamar Braxton. Like, for the very first song that I remember, like, hearing was Love and War. That was mm-hmm. probably the first one that I really, really paid attention to, because I was probably old enough to hear it at that point. But I remember hearing that song, and that's stuck with me to this day. So I've just been a Tamar fan since the beginning. Brandy. Yeah, Brandy, I just, her tone and her run, and, you know, I was just talking to my mom about this, actually. It's like, a lot of people can run, and it's so beautiful, but Brandy's placements, like, her timing is what makes it, it just give you chills, honestly.
Oh.
So, her placement is beautiful. She's beautiful, too. They're all beautiful. And who else did I say? Did I say anybody else?
Beyonce, Brandy, and Tamar.
Right.
So have you seen any of these ladies perform in real life?
Actually, yes. I saw Tamar Braxton perform at a Todrick Hall concert.
Okay.
So that was fine.
Yeah. So sorry, what'd you say?
She slayed. She worked this.
Yes. Yeah, she is confident. She is very confident when she's on stage.
Yes.
So you're a Brandy fan. I'm also a Brandy fan. Are you excited for the show Queens that's coming out in a couple weeks?
Okay, I'm very excited to watch it. Like, I'm super obsessive. Like, when I'm excited about something, I just follow it until it's coming out. So I've been waiting for that, actually.
Yeah, I know. They're pushing it so heavy on TV. I kid you not. I see it pretty much every commercial break, and I'm like, I cannot wait for that show. It looks so amazing.
Right.
So what musicians would you like to collaborate with?
Oh, that's hard, because I love so many different artists. One person that I can say for sure is T-Pain.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, Tamar Braxton, Brandy, Beyonce, that's a given.
Yeah.
There's this artist. I don't know. It's so complicated. This really, I don't know. Erykah Badu, actually.
Yes.
Speaking that existence.
Yes. Yes, I think that would be so amazing if you collab with any of them. But I think T-Pain would be good, because the thing is, everything T-Pain puts out is just a club banger. Like, everybody knows a T-Pain song. You remember where you were when you first heard it, and you're like, oh my gosh, I can't get it out of my head. So it's one of those songs, like, you just always remember.
For sure, for sure. Yeah.
So 2020, you were on season 18 of American Idol. You sung You Are the Reason by Callum Scott. Can you bring us back to that day when you first walked into the room and sang for the judges?
Okay, Oh my God, so much happened that day. Holding area, it was so beautiful. It was like this rooftop. And we've been like waiting all day, and like my entire family was there. So we just in the glistening heat. And it's like cameras here and there. I love the full experience. So that was very, and I was grateful for that. And then I remember walking and I saw the judges. And in my head, I was like, okay, this is definitely a dream. So,
yep.
So I was just so shocked that I couldn't be nervous when I was singing.
Yeah.
Like, that's like very interesting. Like when I'm just in such shock that I don't even feel like I'm here, I just like my nerves just go out the way.
Mm-hmm. And I love that your whole family showed up for you. Like they were outside and like you saw Ryan Seacrest and your family, just the support that they give you. It's so good. I love that they were able to share that experience with you.
Yes. I love this. So grateful for them every single day.
I love that. So why did you choose that song for your audition?
That's just a beautiful song. And I went through like a big list of songs with my family, of course, because we do everything together.
Yeah.
And we say, okay, that's a yes, that's a no. And that was just a really strong choice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I think it was a perfect choice because when the judges heard you sing, they were like, their jaws were on the floor. And then Lionel was like, as soon as you open your mouth, you were a yes. And then he compared you to a young Whitney Houston.
That was big.
Yeah. What an honor. I mean, Lionel has had such a huge career in the industry, and for him to just be speechless and be like, oh my gosh, you are a young Whitney.
Right. That's deep. That's deep.
So amazing. So what's one of the most memorable times that you had on the show?
Definitely Hawaii.
Yeah.
That, you know, Hawaii is just like a dream vacation for a lot of people. And the fact that, like, you know, I was so blessed to go, like, through American Idol, especially going with, like, friends and now family. Like,
yeah,
the cast, they're not my family. Like, I don't even say they're my friends. Like, that's my sister. That's my brother. You know what I'm saying? Like, just the fact that, you know, to be able to go on different floors and be like, okay, yeah, we about to go to the beach. Y'all come join. It was very fun. It's just an experience that you just wouldn't take lightly. You just love it.
Mm-hmm. And that was your first time in Hawaii, yeah?
That was my first time in Hawaii.
Does it look as beautiful as it looks in pictures and on TV?
Yes, I'm planning on going back very soon.
Yes, it looks absolutely magical.
Yeah, it looks so magical, and like I want to go back soon, but I'm looking gonna be sad because I'm not gonna have my crew with me.
Oh yeah, you wonder what you should do if you do go back. You should just be like, we should all meet over there and just kind of have a reunion. That would be fun.
That would be very fun. We just gotta work with everybody's schedule and
definitely,
it's a lot.
Totally. So, what surprised you about your time on Idol?
Going back to the family aspect of the show, like what really surprised me is that like I would have these lifelong friends that's now my family, so that really shocked me because I talk to them like every day still.
Yeah, but you were actually, when you guys were in Hawaii, there was a global pandemic going on,
right?
So how did that change your experience? Because one minute you're all in Hawaii having a good time, and then all of a sudden it's like the world is shutting down. You need to go back to your home and continue your journey from Atlanta.
Right. Yeah. Doing the show in Hawaii, you know, that's when the pandemic first happened. So it wasn't as big as it is now.
Yeah.
Before, you know, you could walk out without your mask on. You can do everything without being vaccinated. So it was a different time. It was almost normal.
So how was it being on the show but being in your house and still being on the show?
I you know, it's just a different experience. You know, being able to do it from home, the fact that we were like one of the first shows to do it from home was like a record, or was, you know, pretty amazing. But I still would have wanted to do it, you know, on stage the way we were originally supposed to do it. But, you know, everything happens for a reason, and, you know, I'm just still grateful for everything. Mm-hmm.
So tell me about some of the friendships that you made on the show, because when I talk to people that have been on these shows, they say, yes, they were my friends, now they're my family. And I love that you said that you talk to them all the time. That's so cool. Tell me about, I guess, a couple of the people from the show that you're really close with.
Really everyone. I don't want to just like say no specific, leave somebody out and they're like, you just saved me. But you know, everybody, I talk to Faith almost like every day.
Yeah.
Robert Taylor from American Idol, talk to him like every day. Elijah, Renee, Olivia Eximenes, I talk to them to her every day. Well, not every day, but we talk occasionally. Oh, you just did an interview with Bilal. I saw that.
Yes, I did.
Yeah, like we're really cool from the show. Like that was amazing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, it's, see, that doesn't like.
Yeah. You and Bilal should work together. He's doing a lot of new music too. I would love to see you guys collab. That'd be so awesome.
Yeah. Okay. We'll talk about that very soon. We gonna happen because that's my fam. Like,
yeah. And I think it's really cool for people who watch these shows to be like, oh my gosh, she's an 18 and those two work together and like those two did a collab together. And it's so cool because for the fans, we still get this experience. Like we saw you by yourself singing, but it's so cool when two different people on the show become friends and then they take, you know, all their artistic abilities and they just kind of like come together and just create this masterpiece.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So let's talk about some of the songs that you've covered. SWV, Demi Lovato, and countless others. What's one of your favorite songs to perform and why?
My favorite song to perform is probably The Prayer, All I Ask, and You Are the Reason. Those are my favorite.
Mm-hmm. And what about those songs make you always want to sing them or you have fun singing them?
Well, The Prayer is just, it's such a deep song. Like, oh, if I just get into the lyrics, it's very spiritual and it's, you know, just asking God to just watch over you wherever you go. So I just, you know, I use those lyrics like in my everyday life. Like I pray, mm-hmm. Oh, prayers, just waking up in the morning. So that song is beautiful. All I Ask is, it's a different level of deep. It's like,
yeah,
can't even get into all that, but it's just a different level, like where you are, like mentally, especially like in a specific space, like,
yeah,
it can help with a lot of different things, or it could make you sad, but you know, and You Are the Reason, it's a sweet, you know, love song about, you know, doing things for a specific person, people.
And like we said earlier, how powerful songwriting is in a piece, because right, like there are countless songs and there's some songs that are on the radio right now that they're not just deep, but they're just, it's catchy, right? But I feel like the songs that you named, they have very deep meaning, and when people hear them, they're moved by them. They're like, yeah, I went through something similar to that.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So I want to talk to you about your single Last Chance. Can we get into the whole like background, the inspiration behind the single?
Well, Last Chance is basically trying to see how I want to word it. Have you ever like been in a situation where it felt like, okay, well, we have to leave each other, so this is literally our last chance to just,
yeah,
get everything out there and see what happens. That's really what it's about.
Mm-hmm. So it's like the final goodbye. Like, this is it. We do what we do.
Like, we gonna get it.
Bye forever. So I want to talk about acting school. I know you've been in acting school. Can you tell us a little bit about your experience?
Well, I have the best acting coach.
Yeah.
Like, he's so fun, and I like that he just goes to like very deep and like reach me on like a mental level. And so like sometimes our sessions, not even like working on the script, sometimes just meditating. And sometimes like, you know, after getting out that meditation, just reading through and then seeing like what can you, you know, what's the word? What can not resonate, but you know.
So you meditate during some of the
I do, and that's very helpful.
Mm-hmm. So what are some other things that he teaches you that maybe were kind of like an aha moment? Like, oh my gosh, okay, now I'm going to apply that to when I read scripts.
Well, he taught me how to break down a script, honestly. So not mm-hmm. just it and they're just words and not just remembering the words that's on the paper. It's like read it and understand like what's happening so that you can better like execute the role, and it's, you know, it's more believable.
Right. Does he tell you to maybe find a feeling or try to say like go to that place mentally, that way it just comes out more naturally?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So how long is the program that you're in?
I'm sorry,
the program, the acting school, like how long is the program?
Well, it's like private coaching. So like, it's how, you know, I want to keep going.
Mm-hmm. So do you eventually want to be an actress as well as a singer?
I do. Yes. Yes.
Cool. So tell me a little bit about what you would like to accomplish in the next 5 years in your career.
Well, I would like to sell out on a tour when things go back to normal, able yep. to around people. I want to win a Grammy.
Mm-hmm.
For sure. I want to get a major acting role. And I still want to go back to like my main purpose of singing, like to inspire people.
Mm-hmm. I love that. And I love how it always comes to inspiring, because when we listen to musicians sing, we want to feel it, and we know when you guys feel it, because we feel it as well. Like I told you earlier when we were talking, when you sang for me, I was like, every time you sing, you give me chills. And I know the people in the chat are with me on that. So guys, put some comments in the chat if when you hear her sing, it gives you chills, and what song you love that she sings.
Thank you. Thank you.
Of course. What song do you wish you wrote and why?
Ooh. Probably Lost One by Jasmine Sullivan.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That song, because it's deep, and it's like the feeling of losing someone, but you don't want them to forget about you, and you don't, you know, it's kind of goes back to like a selfish love. It's like don't love anybody else but me. It's written perfectly. Actually,
yeah, I think it's such an amazing song. Somebody said All I Ask is one of my faves. Yeah, All I Ask. So what does success mean to you?
Success for me means that, you know, I could be proud of myself, or my parents could be proud of me, or I'm just, you know, in a great space, like even mentally,
mm-hmm.
not just like an aspect of wealth or anything, or, you know, just like being able to look at myself as a well-rounded person.
And what do you think it takes to get to that point?
Well, it takes a lot of discipline. It takes a lot of, it takes a good work ethic, though. Like, you can't just want to do something and, like, don't have a way to get it done, or at least try to. You just kind of, it doesn't, like, fall out of thin air. So.
Yeah. So, for, I guess for people who have work ethic, there's people that have it and there's people that don't, right? How do you stay motivated to accomplish your goals?
Well, they're my goals. So that's the motivation in itself. It's like, it's something that I know I have to get to. So that's the motivation. And, you know, when you look at the support, you know, the support that I have, who all came out for me, it's like, you know, I'm doing it for my people, for me.
Yeah. So for people that are looking to try out for American Idol, singers that are possibly watching this right now, what advice would you give to them?
I would say, be who you are, like, stay true to yourself. Don't compare, because look at people, and you're going to see, well, they can do this and I can't do that. Or they can, no, be strong in what you have, be proud of what you have, and just let your light shine. Don't worry about nobody else's.
Yeah. I love that, because I think you just need to be your true, authentic self. Because I've had people on this show before and they're like, I'm in a room with all these people who all can sing. And then they're like, wow, like, someone's going to win this competition. It's like, but they're all my friends.
Right.
Yeah. So it's kind of like, you want to win, but you also want your friends to win.
Right.
So I want to know what's next for you in the next, because we're in October, so we have, you know, two more months left of 2021. Do you have any shows coming up, any collaborations, new music? Talk to us about what's coming.
Well, for his upcoming shows, I'm in a band called Flavor. It was originally my uncle's band, but he's gone now, but the band. So it's a wedding band. So I think that's a corporate band. Sorry, corporate band.
Yeah.
Those gigs here and there. So I have a lot coming up for November and December. And they tell me more about it. Music. I don't have a release date yet, but I know that this EP is coming. And we working on some magic for the supporters.
Nice. Can you tell us how many songs are on it?
I want 7, but the ones that I'm like leaning towards is like 5 right now.
Mm-hmm.
7, so I'm gonna get 7.
Mm-hmm. So talk to us about the best advice you've ever been given. What was that?
I think about that. I get a lot of advice on a daily, actually. Let's see. I don't know. I get advice every day. So it's like, I can't just, because I talk to my mom a lot.
Yeah.
You know, we talk about everything. So it's like, in a regular conversation, it's some type of advice.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Okay. I'll rephrase it. So, of the conversations you've had with your mom recently, what one piece of advice has she said to you that you're like, yeah, that's good advice?
Probably just like knowing your worth. And, you don't have to be weak for something, because, you know, it's complicated. I don't know how to word it. But just knowing your worth, really, and standing your ground.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's so important to just stand your ground, not settle for like less than, and just know who you are.
Right.
Mm-hmm. What advice would you give to other people looking to start their career as a singer?
I would say, if this is what you want, just work towards it and it will happen for you. Pray. Mm-hmm. Make sure you get content out. Get music out,
mm-hmm.
and just try your hardest, like, and pray about it, seriously.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I think what you said about content is so important, because I think there are a lot of great singers, but they're scared to put content out. But definitely, we need to see you and we need to hear you, because you never know how somebody could potentially find you. Someone might reach out to you and just say, hey, I came across this video that you did, and it was so awesome.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So talk to us about social media. Where can all the people watching, obviously people are on Instagram watching us, but plug all the social media that you're on.
Okay, TikTok is Cyniah.Elise, Cyniah.Elise. YouTube, Cyniah space Elise. Instagram, Cyniah.Elise. Twitter, Cyniah underscore Elise. But anything else? Facebook, Cyniah Elise. So everything is Cyniah Elise.
That's easy enough. So, how can people watching right now support you, Sanaya, as a musician?
Well, the people watching me, you can follow me on social media. Listen to my single Last Chance, and I also have another song with this amazing artist, Jane Anna, Letter to Bay.
Okay.
That's the vibe. So
yeah,
y'all go listen to all my music.
Awesome. So that's all the questions that I have for you this evening, but you're gonna sing for us, so take it away.
So this one is All I Ask. Second one is my audition song, You Had a Reason.
Some of these comments back to you. I love her voice. Chills. Sing. Chills. Nick says, go girl. Raptured says, sing.
Oh, thank you. I can't see any of the comments, actually.
Oh, you can't?
Mm-mm.
Comments? Ansel says, I love this song. Let Me Find Out says, that's my wedding song.
Oh!
Amazing! Wild About Jazz says, yes. Exerza says, great control of your vocals.
Thank you.
Papa DeChef says, that you are the reason. I think he was singing with you while you were singing. So, guys, this is the time of the show where if you have a question for Cyniah, please feel free to put it in the comment section below, and I'll read the questions to you because you still can't see them, right?
I can just see who joined.
Oh, okay. Okay, no worries. So, yeah, if anybody has any questions, feel free to put them in the comments section below. We're going to hang tight. So you've lived in Atlanta your whole life, right?
I have, yes.
Awesome. What are some cool things to do in Atlanta?
We have Atlantic Station.
Yeah.
It's like a hangout spot, you know?
Yeah.
It's so much here, but when you live here, it's almost like it ain't nothing.
Right, because you've done it so much.
Right. We have a lot of cute, like, little hangout spots, though. We have, like, these painting chip if you drink or not. I don't drink because I'm not old enough. But I go paint and sip some apple juice, okay? like, jazz fest and stuff like that.
So, what are a couple of your favorite restaurants that you like to go to?
Okay, so they shut my spot down, but it was this Japanese steakhouse, and that was like my all-time favorite, and that hurt my heart, like, when they shut it down. Where else do I go? Oh, there's this place called Taqueria Tsunami. It's like an Asian Latin fusion type thing, and it's so good.
Yeah.
I don't know about a favorite. I don't know. I can't think of a favorite. I like Carrabba's, though. I eat Carrabba's.
Mm-hmm. So this Asian fusion, like, Latin place, what do you like to get there?
Okay, so I get the Baja tacos, and it's like fried fish tacos.
Yeah.
And I get cauliflower wings because I'm a pescatarian.
Okay. Cauliflower wings are good.
They're really good. Like, get into that.
Yeah. And what's the name of the spot called?
Taqueria Tsunami.
Okay. Cool. How about music venues in Atlanta?
Atlantic Station, we literally just had Afropunk in Atlantic Station. There was like a couple artists there. I don't know about, like, venues, but, like, different pop-up areas where you can just kind of set up. Well, actually, the Symphony Hall.
Mm-hmm.
Fox Theater.
Okay.
Yeah, we got a lot of stuff. Fox Theater, it's just not coming to me. That whole strip, like, everything down there is beautiful.
Yeah.
To go walk, really. Like, Atlanta, go take pictures. Go take pictures. Yeah.
I've actually never been to Atlanta before. I've heard beautiful things about it. Like, everybody raves about it. So when I talk to someone who's from Atlanta, I always like to say, like, what do you recommend? What are the spots, like, you'd like to go to? Because then eventually when the world opens up, I can have, like, a list of things to go to, you know?
Okay, so let me tell you. You have to go to Pont City Market.
Okay.
Pont City Market, there's a lot of things in there. Like, we have this rooftop. And it looks like they got, like, what's that thing called when you, it's not pinball, it's not foosball, but it's a ball thing, and you roll it up, and it's fun. It looks like a mini, like a carnival, kind of.
Okay.
But it's really fun. You gotta go to Pond City Market. Yeah. It's just, the whole city is a vibe. You gotta, Botanical Gardens, right? I see that.
Yep.
It's beautiful.
Okay, I'm gonna look at some of these questions that we got. Hold on a second. Okay, hold on. Someone says, how do I book you for my wedding?
Okay, so you can book me through my email, but because you're in the chat, you can just go ahead and DM me and I'll see it and I'll send you all of my booking information. So that'll be easier for you.
Uh-huh. Ansel says, is there an album on the way?
Yes, there's an EP right now. And then after that, but it's coming, y'all. Soon come, it's coming.
It's coming, guys. Just hang tight.
Yes, I'm so ready. It's almost like whenever.
Geneva says, will you sing at my house for Thanksgiving?
I will come sing for Thanksgiving. I sure will. Oh, wait, who's that? Oh, that's my cousin. Hey.
Oh, okay. Well, I guess maybe you're probably going to see her anyway.
You know, you going to sing for the one?
Raptured says, how old were you when you first sung on stage?
Okay, so the very first time I ever, like, sung on stage in front of a crowd, whatever, was at church. I was 2 years old.
Yep.
Church, where my mother directed the choir, so.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
Very cool. Do you have any bucket list venues that you would like to perform at?
Well, okay, I don't know if it's held at the same place, but the Grammys, for sure. Fox Theater.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, everywhere, really. Like, everywhere, like, where the greats have stepped foot in.
Yeah. So, do you have any final words for the room?
Well, I just want to say thank you guys for joining this live and supporting my journey. I want to thank my family for supporting me through everything all the time. And yes, follow all my social media and listen to my songs, Last Chance and Letter to Me. And mm-hmm. Wait for more stuff coming.
Yes, new music is coming soon. It's definitely coming. So, Cyniah, I just wanted to say, you're the only person on my show so far that has thanked their family in that last closing. Because people are like, oh, yeah, thanks so much for your support. You know, follow here. I have tickets to this or whatever. But, like, no one has said thank you to their family. And I love that you said that. That's amazing.
Gotta thank them. You know, they the reason. They the reason. Okay.
I love it. So guys, if you don't already, please make sure to follow her on all social media platforms. New music is coming soon. Share the music. Tell people you know about the music. Put it in your stories. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Cyniah is coming with awesome new music. Hopefully before the end of the year, maybe?
Yes, hopefully.
Okay. Okay, we're hanging tight. We're waiting. Cyniah, we lost you!
Okay, I'm sorry. Yeah, my phone ran hot and it just cut everything.
Okay! It's okay. I was like, oh, she did not just go already. So, just wanted to say thank you so much for spending your evening with us. We're so, so excited to hear the new music. You're going to have to let me know when things drop and you can come back on and we can talk about all the new music and creative process and all that good stuff. Sound good?
Well, thank you for having me.
Of course, it was so much fun, and stay safe, you know, be true to yourself. And guys, if you're in the chat right now, please support good musicians. If you know musicians, independent musicians, please support them, buy their music, buy their merch, share them on social media. Because the thing is, musicians need all of us. They need all of our support, right?
Right. Thank you. Thank you for saying that. We wouldn't have anything without the support.
Yeah. What else can we do to support you and other musicians?
Really just, like, staying up to date with the music, you know, following us, joining the lives can really help. And make sure you just share. Like, even if you have friends that are just doing anything, always support your friends. Like, you know, we always support people we don't know. Support your people.
I think it's really important to support your friends. Like, for instance, if your friend has a candle making business, right? Maybe you don't like candles, but if you post their story and say, oh, hey, my girl sells candles, you might have, you know, 1,000 followers, and one of your followers might be like, oh my gosh, the holidays are coming up, and a candle is a perfect gift for somebody. So yeah, even if you can't support your friend, just make sure that your people know to support your friend, because that always helps to like, share, follow. And so, yeah, you're totally right. Support your friends. I completely agree with that. So I just want to say thank you again for sharing your Saturday night with us, Cyniah. Your beautiful gift. We're so excited to hear the new music. And like I said, support great music. We will see you guys next time. Have a great weekend.
All right. Bye, guys. Thank you.
Thanks, bye-bye.